Good morning friends, I am Dr. Tushar Vankhede, Associate Professor in Botany, Shri Shivaji Science College, Amravati. Firstly, I welcome you all for the 5-day national workshop on NEET State Guidance for JRF and Lectureship under the CSIR. I also welcome under the platform, online platform Botany for You. Friends, earlier I have given my lectures on the career guidance. Now actually I am coming for those topics which comes under UGC CSIR examination. So the life sciences topic consists of different types of unit. One of them, unit number 6, is regarding the system of physiology, that is the plant physiology. Two physiologies are there, one of them is the animal and second is the plant physiology. Now everybody knows about the plant physiology, but the basic heart of the plant physiology consists of the CO2 fixation, and the points under these photosynthesis are light harvesting complexes, then mechanism of their electron transport, then it's a photoprotective mechanism is there, second C3 pathway, C4 pathway and CM pathway. So let us discuss one by one, as this topic is a very lengthy one, we will choose certain points there. Now look here, one of the greatest scientists, Albert Einstein, said that look deep into the nature and then you will understand everything better. So the life of processes consist of photosynthesis and respiration. We have to look at two ways. One of them is the cellular level and second at the molecular level. Important thing is that which is the source of energy for this universe. In this universe, the main source is coming from the sun. Because sun's radiations, they bring life on this particular earth. So, sun's energy results into the one chemical synthesis of food materials, and we call them as the photosynthesis. Now, life on this ultimately earth is depend upon the producers, and that is the supposed to be the green plants. So, energy is derived from the sun. Another one, photosynthesis, literally we mean it as a synthesis using the light. And light energy derives synthesis of carbohydrates, that is the food material, glucose, from using the raw material, that is the carbon dioxide and the water. And it also generates one of the novel type of a gas, that is called as the life of our life gas, that is the oxygen. Now, it is said that 6 molecules of carbon dioxide and again 6 molecules of water molecules previously supposed to be utilized for the synthesis of a glucose molecule, but this reaction is supposed to be now modified, and we are considering that the 12 molecules of what? H2O molecules. So 6 CO2 plus 12 H2O, in the presence of the sun's radiations, it will convert it to glucose, that is CH2O6, and it liberates the 6 molecules of oxygen along with the 6 molecules of water molecule. So Van Helmont, he utilized one of the soil experiment, that is he just put some water in a different types of a pots and he made measure its weight, and he found that different types of pots having a different types of weight, and then he suggested there may be a possibility of the food material synthesis. Then Julius Sachs, 1862, showed photosynthesis occurs in the chloroplast. Everybody knows about this there, but it has some ecological significance. If photosynthesis is done there, then remember there will be a regulation of the food chain in an ecological sense. Not only food chain, there will be a regulation of a food web. Food web, that is the multi-type of tropic level or food level we can see. But the main heart is the producers here. So that's why photosynthesis is very much important there. Now, in case of photosynthesis concerned, it is related with the light, photo light. So light has the two types of features here. For example, it has either a waveform or it may be a particle form. So this wavelength is always denoted by the lambda, which is a disturbed to the successive wave in the test. So here, look here, this is the distance between the two types of a wave, and it is forming the trough and the crest. And it is also denoted by S equal to lambda v, that is the speed of the wavelength. Second, one of the important thing is that light is also act as a particle. That is, in the terms of a particle, that is the packets of quantum zones. So either it is in the waveform or it may be a quantum zone. So this is the most important property of the light. That's why this function can be possible on this in this universe. Then why these plants are look green? We know that when sun radiation reaches to the earth, it gives different types of radiations. For example, gamma rays, X-rays are there, radio waves are there. But only this in between them, this in between the ultraviolet and infrared, we get the visible light. If this is the visible light, then we know that in that visible light, the wavelength that is coming from the 400 angstrom to the 700 angstrom, we get different types of colors, seven colors of the light. And in between them, two colors are very important, that is the blue and the red, which is actively take part in the photosynthetic reactions. As far as the role of light is concerned, look here. As far as the radio waves is concerned and its penetration power is concerned, its wavelength is short, is long, but however, the size is very large one. As compared to the gamma rays, again, look here, its penetration power is very high, but they cannot able to reach to the earth. This is the property of the light. And why these plants look green? If we know that chloroplast is present in the leaves, and these are lights which are incident coming from the sun, they get reflected. And this reflection in the terms of the green light, then we can visualize the plants as a one of the green substances, because green is supposed to be reflected due to the chlorophyll there. Now, two things are said in our syllabus. What is the absorption spectrum? And second is the action spectrum. Absorption spectrum is nothing but it shows the light which is typically absorbed by the leaf. Not a leaf, not for this metabolic activity, but it is absorbed by the leaf. However, in case of action spectrum, it is actually the light is utilized for the process of a photosynthesis. So that is absorption and action spectrum. If you are known about your bubblers, Wilbert bubblers experiment, where we can see that this blue and the green, blue and red light, they give the higher percentage of absorption and the reaction of photosynthesis. Now, different types of pigments are there. For example, principal pigments are the chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B are the principal pigments. Second, accessory pigment, that is, for example, carotenoids, phycobilins, or we can also call them as a xanthophyll or phycoerythrin. So, important, the reaction centers are located in the chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B. If the color of a plant is a green, red, it may be a yellowish, but even this accessory pigment having the color pigments are there, but main reaction center will be located in a chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B only, whatever the color of the leaf is there. This is the structure of the chlorophyll molecules. In this chlorophyll molecule, looks here, this is the at center is the magnesium attached with the 4 nitrogen, and we call them as a porphyrin head. However, long phytol tank you can observe, and it is called as a hydrocarbon tail is there. This chlorophyll pigment is supposed to be embedded in the thylakoid membrane in between the lipids. So it is a protein molecule, and it is embedded into the two sandwich of the bilipid layers of the thylakoid membrane. Main feature, if this magnesium is present there, this is the green color of the plant is due to the presence of this magnesium. For example, in case of a red RBCs are there, red color is due to the hemoglobin. Hemoglobin attached with what? Ferrous molecules. So that's why color will be the red. But here, color of the plants, which is look like a green, is due to the presence of this magnesium. Then this is one of the structure of the chlorophyll A and chlorophyll molecule. In these two structures, only feature is that only this particular here CH3 will be replaced. That makes different between the chlorophyll and chlorophyll B molecule. Then this is the chemistry of autumn of the leaf. If you come for the first year, look just like a grain, evergreen. When you will leave our college at that time, this will be the first one. That will be the leaves will be fall down. So at that time, it will be the two synthesis of the certain type of pigments there. For example, chlorophyll are there, carotenoids just like a somewhat yellowish. Some of the carotenoids just like a brown there. Anthocyanin and carotene mix such type of a reddish type of a leaves. In case of blue color, some anthocyanins produce the blue colors there. Now, what is the location of the chloroplast? Chloroplasts are generally placed in the upper surface of the leaves, and specifically after the epidermis, you can see that there will be palisade cells and the spongy parenchyma cells. In these palisade cells, you will find that depending upon plant and species, you will find 20 to 100 numbers of chloroplasts embedded in the palisade cells. So these are the oval shaped, egg type of a cells, and color is the green. Second, chloroplasts are the part of the plastids depending upon their function. For example, leucoplast in case of onion, it is the storage. The plastids are the storage of food material. However, in case of our green plants, chloroplast is supposed for the photosynthetic one. Okay, in case of chromoplast, you will get the different types of the pigments. So shape, size, and the number is variable. For example, in case of papaya, you will get the papaya leaves, you will get the larger number of what chloroplast in the leaves of the papaya plant. Then this is the photosynthetic roadmap. Look here, light energy is supposed to be trapped by photosynthetic reaction center, and we call them as an antenna complex, light harvesting complex. So light reaction will be first feature, pioneer feature, where light energy trapped and it will produce the ATP and NADPH molecule that will be act as one of the source to go for the dark reaction. And under dark reaction, sugars will be synthesized, and once the food is synthesized, it will be go for the cellular respiration, cellulose formation, body parts formation, and also the synthesis of a certain organic compounds like growth hormones as well as the vitamins. Now this is the overview of the photosynthetic process. In this photosynthetic process, look here, two locations can be easily seen. Number one, the light reaction will be used in the which part of the chloroplast, that is the light reaction took place in the thalamocortical region. Second, the granum region, which is the stroma region, which is present there will be a initiation of the what Kelvin cycle. So CO2 is supposed to be utilized, it is supposed to be trapped, and O2 will be released, is the final destination of this photosynthesis process. Now in these two types of photosynthesis, they cooperate with one another. For example, look here, this is the reaction center number one. In this, we can say that electrons are expelled, and these electrons, once they are expelled to the another higher energy level, it will be picked up by the another higher energy level, and it will be transported through a series of chains, and that will produce the ATP molecule. So after production of ATP molecule, it also initiate the production of NADPH2 molecule. So what is the main feature of light reaction? If light is not there, then this particular reaction could not be took place there. So this is the one of the wonderful thing. So how many events took place in the photosynthesis? The primary event is the photon is supposed to be captured. Photon, light is supposed to be captured there, and the electrons which are present in that pigment is expelled. Then there will be transfer of reaction center with the specialized growth pigments. Then electrons are transported, shuttled, and series of electrons are passed through the different types of a carrier molecules, and protons are also transported across the membrane. Not only electrons, protons are also transported there. And due to the proton transport, generally chemoosmosis is generally present, generally took place, and that results in the synthesis of ATP molecules. Now, light is supposed to be trapped in the thalamocortical membrane, as earlier I was said there, and there will be a splitting of molecule to release the oxygen from the water molecules. That is the main feature here. Then water breakdown into hydrogen ions, electrons, and the oxygen gas. This is it. And the two products of the light dependent reaction of the photosynthesis photosystems are the ATP and NADPH2. Okay, look here. This is the cyclic photophosphorylation. This process of ATP generation is associated with some photosynthetic bacteria. So reaction center is the 700 nm wavelength. Now, in case of photosystem 1, once the light is incident on the reaction or antenna system, electrons are expelled. Two electrons are supposed to be expelled. Second, after that, 2 plus 2, 4 electrons are expelled here to the primary ferredoxygen receptor. It goes to the ferredoxygen. During ferredoxygen, this NADP with the help of NADP reductase converted into the NADPH2. And this NADPH2 is coming from the photosystem 1, photosystem 2. Now, in case of photosystem 1, it is called as a cyclic photophosphorylation, where the electron which is excited after getting from the primary ferredoxygen, it will be goes to the cytochrome C complex and again it will be regained by the photosystem 1, that is the cyclic pathway. That's why it is called as a photosystem 1, that is cyclic 1. Non-cyclic, here only the difference is that when the light is incident on the antenna system number 2, that is the photosystem 2, 680, that is the wavelength is there, it is absorbed. And during this absorption, two electrons are excited from one plant, another two, so four electrons generally expelled here, and they transport into the electron transport chain. Due to that electron, during the electron transport chain, two more main things will be happen. Number one, ATP will be synthesized at our ATP mill during the continuous transport through this particular electron cytochrome carrier. These are the protein complexes. And these excelled, when it will be excelled, electron will be expelled into non-cyclic photophosphorylation, it will be fall into the photosystem 1. That's why it will be not come back. So it will be non-cyclic one there. And previously what happens in the photosystem 1, the major event is the photolysis of water. Water split into the hydrogen ions and the oxygen gas. And that's why this hydrogen which is split up here, we call them as the protons. It is also called as Z scheme of electron transport. In sometimes the question asks as a Z scheme. So it is nothing but Z scheme. It is a zigzag scheme of electron transport. That's why it is called as a Z scheme of the light reaction, consists of photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. And it is dependent upon light harvesting complex to the electron receptor. Electron receptor to the light harvesting complex 1. And from light harvesting complex 1, it is again goes for the electron acceptor ferredoxygen molecules. So this is called as Z scheme of molecules. So again, this is the Z scheme of molecule. It will show you how this energy is energy of electrons goes there. Look here, this is the photosystem 1. These are the antenna complex. For example, you have seen the photocells there. They looks like a photocell. And in this photocell, this H2O molecule first split up into the two protons, hydrogen protons and one half of the O2, that is the gas here. So this hydrogen, which is coming from the water molecule, is transported for the NADPH2. It is goes for the formation of a NADP into the NADPH2. And second, during expiration of electrons, the energy is transported in such a way that the first acceptor is the plastocumene. Then plastocumene goes to the B6F complex. Then plastocyanin is the another component there, and it goes to the photosystem 1. So if we can able to break up this chain, for example, you have heard about certain types of the weedicide or herbicides, pesticides. So what they block here, they block this particular channel. Look here, this photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. This is the photosystem 1 here, photosystem 2. Or if you spray certain type of a thunder like a weedicide, so they block the photo light reaction of the plant. If light reaction is a break up there, then there will be no synthesis of a food, and ultimately the weed will be died there. So this is the principle behind the herbicides. Now look here, four complexes you have to get acquainted there. Number one is photosystem 1 or 2, second B6F complex, photosystem 1, and number 4 is the NADP reductase. So these are the, when you will write the answer, you have to understand this part, you have to know this this part. Now look here, this is the excited state of the electron, and here higher energy level will be always there. Now there will be question asked, that is the about the proton transport in a photosynthesis. Many times students say that, sir, there is an electron transport. What is the proton transport? Electron transport is supposed to be known for the photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. But proton transport is also related with the photosystem 1 and 2, where the photolysis of water and formation of NADPH2 is related with the proton transport. What about the electron transport? ATP is supposed to be related for the electron transport. So look here, after splitting of hydrogen molecule, and this is the stroma and lumen of the our chloroplast. Here you can say that this is the chemiosmosis. Chemiosmosis processes come under mitochondria and as well as in a chloroplast. So suppose this is one of the three dimensional structure of the synthesis of ATP and NADPH molecule. As I said, the chemiosmosis in a chloroplast is due to the two reactions there. Number one, they result in the change in the pH of the two media, inner and outer media, and second, it is osmosis done with the pressure, that is the gradient pressure from higher to the lower concentration is transported. So this F1 just like our F1 particles in the mitochondria, here this ATPase complex will be utilized. This proton from the water molecule will be expelled. Your concentration will be higher in this particular thallocadium membrane, and it will be expelled to the stroma region. Concentration higher, if they accumulate more, then it will be expelled, and during that expelled, it is come through the which part, that is the ATPase enzyme, which convert ADP into inorganic phosphate to form the ATP molecule. So that is the main feature here. Now look here, this is the light reaction and the dark reaction, which is supposed to be correlated with one another. Light reaction will be followed by dark reaction. So it is related with the steps of light reaction: absorption of light, photolysis of water, then reduction of NADP into the NADPH2, and last one is the photophosphorylation, that is the synthesis of ATP molecules. So the credit goes to the Malvin Kelvin. That's why it is also called as the C3 cycle or Kelvin cycle. Now, if we go to the some animations, so let us see what actually happens when light is incident on this in this process
of carbon dioxide.
Look here, number one, our carbon dioxide and water molecules, which are supposed to be used for the synthesis of food material. Second, CO2 I will use as a raw material, water I will use as a raw material, and second, energy, which is the physical entity. But remember, this physical entity is supposed to be converted into the chemical entity. Okay, so look here, this is the first waveform. Look here, I said a light can be a wave, a light can be a photon. Photon is terms of the particle. Just in my previous slide, we have gone through this concept. Now, what happened? It will be going in the terms of the wave. Wave having the certain type of the wavelength there. And during that wavelength, just I explained there, this is the UV light. And in UV light, we have got the different types of what? Color spectrum. Now, this is the photon. Photons coming, just look out, this is the photons are coming in the terms of the packets of the cell, packets of the energy, in the terms of quantums, and they fall on the leaf surface. And on that leaf surface, we know that it contains the chlorophyll, so green and the yellow light, it's directly reflected, and that's why it can be visible to you and me. So human eyes are susceptible for that, as the reflection is there. So inside them is the palisade cell. Inside that palisade cell, look here, in the palisade layer, you find that there is a presence of the chloroplast. Okay, so inside that chloroplast, the structure of chloroplast, we are known about the chloroplast structure. So inside the chloroplast, look like these are the stack of thallocadium membranes. You much known about the electric poles. They have some Chinese type of a stack, that is insulators. So just like that insulator here, the thallocadium membrane are arranged one upon another, and it will be forms a very beautiful stack of the structures. On the lumen, that is on the periphery of that particular thallocadium membrane, look, it will be made up of a liquid bilayer model, just like our plasma membrane. So inside them, here is the localization of the photosystem 1 and photosystem 2. Previously, I have given some concept regarding the diagrams, because we are known about the diagrams. We understood the thing in the basis of a diagram there. So this is the diagram. Diagram of what? Diagram of photosystem 1 and photosystem 2 in the terms of some molecular basis. So electrons supposed to be received these photons or light energy, and these electrons are excited here. And the excited electrons are carried by the different types of the carriers. So what is the feature of the carrier? Every carrier will receive this molecule, and again it will transport to the another protein carrier. So different types of the carriers are there, and in between them the charged electron molecule is transported to the different carrier molecules for the synthesis of what? The synthesis of a ATP molecules or splitting of water molecules. Now in between that, if this is the water molecules, this water molecules after reaction with the particular electrons, they split up into the oxygen, and second they split up into the plus, that is the H plus, that is called as the protons. Now the electrons are transported from the intermediate trace of the thylakoid membrane, and this is your proton molecules, they come across this particular thylakoid trace. Okay, so depending upon the concentration of the hydrogen molecules, this is the mill, or it is the called as the world's smallest rotor, that is the ATPase complex. And once this splitting of water molecule result into production of the water, H plus, splitting of the water molecule results into the formation of H plus ions, and this H plus ions is utilized for the synthesis of what? ATP molecule, as well as some of the hydrogen molecule is transported for the synthesis of NADP into the NADH2. So if ATP are synthesized due to the hydrogen atom, and NADPH2 also reduced to NADPH2 is also due to the presence of these protons, that is the proton transport. So electrons and proton transport are related here, and once light reaction is completed there, we know that it goes to the dark reaction, that is the Kelvin cycle. During the Kelvin cycle, what happened here? Look, during the Kelvin cycle, the CO2 carbon dioxide is supposed from the environment is fixed by the enzyme, that is called as the R2BP carboxylase. This carbon fixation will be done there, and in during this carbon fixation, look here, carbon fixation consists of what? What does this particular carbon molecule get diffused then, and to the formation of the two molecules of the 3-phosphoglyceric acid, and that's why this is the 3-phosphoglyceric acid, we call them as the 3-PGA and also the C3 cycle, and again it reduced one by one, it is reduced to the what reduction process, that is once it is reduced along with the utilization of ATP and NADP, ADPH2, the energy which is synthesized during the light reaction is utilized in a dark reaction. During that dark reaction, once it will be reduced to give a photosynthetic product, that is we call them as the carbohydrates. So carbohydrates which is synthesized, that is the glucose 3-phosphate. This glucose 3-phosphate again regenerated to give the which RUBP carbon RUBP. Now the synthesis of a carbon glucose molecule which is you are looking here, this molecule gets stored in the different tissues of the cells, plant cells, and once it is stored there, there will be a starch molecule, because it is the stored molecule which is not easily visible with the water molecule. It will be stored as a starch, and whenever the food material is required, the starch will be again converted into the what? Again, it will be converted into simple substances. So that is the main feature here. Now, students, what about the CO2 fixation? But have you heard about the O2 fixation? Look here. If a gas, O2 gas, is supposed to be trapped by a RUBP carboxylase, then this RUBP oxygenase enzyme can able to fix the O2 molecule also, and due to that O2 molecule fixation, there will be what happens? There will be a two glycolate component will be synthesized, and then that two glycolate compound will result into the photorespiration. But CO2 is trapped by a RUBP, that is the RUBP carboxylase, then it goes for the Kelvin cycle. So in case of Kelvin cycle, look here, earlier I have given you the concept of three phases are there. So carbon reduction is there, with the help of ATP and NADPH2, then reduction is reduced into the formation of a glucose molecule. And again, this glucose molecule get regenerated for the continuation of the ribulose 1,5 biphosphate. So number one is the process of carboxylation, where the CO2 molecule combined for the 5 carbon to give the 6 carbon, 2 molecules of the 6 carbon molecules. Then there will be reduction, there will be and the regeneration is also there. So in C3 cycle, generally it is also called like a thermochemical cycle or biochemical cycle. So, or either we call them as a Kelvin cycle or dark reaction. So, carboxylation, look here, how REBP get a first stable product, that is the 3-phosphoglycerate, by a chain of reaction here. Now, in a regeneration phase, what happened there? The ribose diphosphate is regenerated, and the regenerated phase is called as a pentose phosphate pathway or hexose monophosphate shunt. So, it goes to the formation of dihydroxyacetone phosphate, and again they converted with the help of a aldolase to into the fructose 1,6 diphosphate. So fructose 1,6 diphosphate to the fructose 6 phosphate, and it will be stored as a food material there. Now after the synthesis of this fructose 6 phosphate, again we want to regenerate the phase. So food material is synthesized. Now it will be break up to give to continuation of the reaction, and again it will split up into the phosphoglycerate into the ribulose 1,5 biphosphate, and two reaction centers are there. They split into the erythrose 4 phosphate and xerulose 5 phosphate. Now erythrose and xerulose 5 phosphate, again they reduce to give pseudoheptulose 1,7 diphosphate. Then pseudoheptulose 1,7 diphosphate gives rise to the xerulose 7 phosphate. Now the xerulose and another component, they go to the third step, where two reaction center parallelly goes to form the ribose 5 phosphate, and again ribose 5 phosphate gives rise to the another product, that is the xerulose ribulose 1,5 diphosphate. Now in this particular dark reaction, CO2 is fixed to carbohydrates and the CO2 acceptor ribulose diphosphate is generated. In Kelvin cycle, 12 NADPH2 and 18 ATPs are required to fix the 6 molecules into the 1 hexose sugar molecules. Now this is one of the schematic diagram. Now look here, whatever I have said regarding the xylulose and fructose 6 phosphate, erythrose 4 phosphate. Now two pathways you can see here. For the formation, our ultimate aim is the we have to synthesize the ribulose 5 phosphate, or ribulose 5 phosphate gives rise to the ribulose 1,5 biphosphate, which is the receptor for the all molecules. So it can be go by three ways. Look here, three steps are there. Step 6, that is the glyceraldehyde 3 phosphate goes to the dihydroxyacetone phosphate for the fructose 1,6 phosphate, and it will go for the fructose 1,6 phosphate to give erythrose and xerulose 5 phosphate. Directly it can be go to the aldolase via fructose 1,6 phosphate. Directly it can be also goes through the ribulose 1,5 phosphate. Those three steps are there for the regeneration of the what? Regeneration of the RUBP. Now another is the C4 cycle or H-like pathway. So it is the alternate pathway of the C3 cycle with the CO2. So though the plants, that is generally called grasses are there, sugar canes are there, maize are there, sorghum, amaranthus there, chinopodium there. Here we can see the C4 cycle there. We also called it as H-like cycle. C4 plants, the chloroplast are dimorphic in nature. Look here in this diagram. Here you can see the vascular bundles are surrounded by bundle sheet of larger parenchymate cells with the chloroplast there. So the chloroplast in the mesophylls are the similar and always contain the grana, that is the granule region. While the chloroplast in the bundle sheet cells are large and they non-granule and they contain the starch grains. So two dimorphic means two types of what? Two types of chloroplast can be seen there. Now in this particular diagram, we can see that it is called as a trans anatomy. The peculiar anatomy of the leaves of C4 plants, that is called as a trans anatomy, where bundle sheet cells are bigger and look like a ring or the wreath. That is the ornamentation type of a word. The trans in the German means wreath, hence it is called as a trans type of anatomy. So look here, So there is mesophyll cells, and in case of your these bundle sheet cells, here we can find two different types of a chloroplast. Look here, in a single chloroplast, grana portion, light reaction, stoma, that is the dark reaction, same will be happen there. So if it is the, in this particular diagram, atmospheric CO2 is coming there, it will be trapped in the mesophyll cell. And the first product which is synthesized for the synthesized, that is the phosphoenol pyruvate. Now this CO2 is fixed in a C4 acid, it is the 4 carbon acid, and then look here, it will be transported to the from the bundle sheet cells, where it will be fixed via C3 cycle. And for after fixation, for their regeneration will be took place again in the mesophyll cell. So reaction is same, photosynthesis reaction is same, but there will be two types of reaction centers are there. Now the C4 cycle involves again carboxylation, breakdown of the materials, splitting of the materials, and again the phosphorylation. So one is coming at one bundle sheet cell, another in the mesophyll cells. So this is the first reaction of carboxylation, where phosphoenol pyruvic acid goes to form oxaloacetic acid, that is the 4 carbon. Now it is reduced to the aspartate gives to malate, again decarboxylation is there. After decarboxylation, again it will be split into phosphoenol pyruvate, and again there will be regeneration, and the process will be continued. In this small diagram, we can see that in mesophyll cells, a primary level, the carbon dioxide is fixed here. In bundle sheet cells, C3 cycle will be regulated here, and again the sugars which are synthesized, after synthesized, they again transported to where? Again they are transported to the mesophyll cells, and this reaction is carried out by the which two reaction center reaction acids are there, that is the pyruvic acid and the malic acid. So this is the region: mesophyll cells, granule chloroplast. Bundle sheet says a granule chloroplast, means it is for the which one? It is for the dark reaction. So always remember, that's why C3 cycle, C4 cycle having a two type of a destinations in the mesophyll cells and bundle sheet cells. Even this is the one of the graphical representation I would like to present here. Here CO2 coming from the environment, fixed in the mesophyll cells, then transported with the help of oxaloacetate, 4 carbon compound is there. In 4 carbon compound, malate break up to give 3 carbon pyruvate. Pyruvate is eliminated here. Then bundle sheet CO2 will be fixed in a Kelvin cycle. And this CO2, where do you get this CO2? CO2 will be transported to the muscular tissue. So this is the one of the small feature of the C4 cycle. Remember here, C4 cycle is a mixture of C3 and C4 cycle. C3 cycle is a only single one. So this is the difference between, it occurs in a mesophyll cell, but it occurs in a mesophyll as well as bundle sheet cell. That is the basic difference between C3 and C4 pathways are there. Now, any factors are affect there? Yes, different types of environmental factors affect the rate of photosynthesis there. Like for example, if you increase the wavelength there, if you increase the concentration of a CO2 there, concentration of the water there, but after picking high rate of photosynthesis, it will be go in a plateau state, or it is we call them as a which stage, that is the stable phase. So whatever environmental condition you produce there, it will follow the Blackmann's law. That is that if your process is conditioned by different types of several factors, then the reaction will be controlled by the pace of its slowest factor. That is the Blackmann's law there. Then last one is the crassulacean acid metabolism. Now look, we know that the agave, cactus, or bromeliad plants. So these plants, fleshy plants, so they are adapted to the arid conditions, drought conditions. So look here, in that condition, during the day period, the environmental conditions are very, very unfavorable. At that time, the stomata get closed, and the stomata get opened during the night one, so that they reduce the water content. They reduce their, reduce the efficiency of the plant, so that they can able to conserve the water. So, or also we said that it can be able to prevent the evaporation of the water. Now, in this plant, the CO2 is stored in the 4 carbon acid malate, and then it is reacted with the rubisco to produce sugar through photosynthesis at the day. For example, plant, cactus, cactus or pineapple. What actually happens here? The flagellation acid metabolism is related with the opening and closing of the stomata. Now, this stomata, during the daytime, what happens? This malic acid are synthesized from the vacuole and they release malate into the cell cytoplasm. And due to that, this malate get reduced NADP into the NADPH2. And due to this reaction, the Calvin cycle is activated and starch are supposed to be produced. But in this part, the stomata are closed there. During the night period, what happens there? The malic acid, which is synthesized in a particular cytoplasm, it is a reverse back starch, that is called as the starch malic acid hypothesis. This malic acid coming used for the synthesis of a starch material again reduced to the triphosphate, phenylenol, pyruvate, and it gets reduced to the alkyl acetate. Due to this reaction, this NADH2 again reduced to the NAD and malate is released, and this malic acid again goes to the inside the vacuole, and due to that vacuole, the stomata, which is having two types of guard cells, their pH get decreased and the stomata again closed there. So during stomata gets open there. So during night period, you will find that stomata open, and that stomata which are opened there, they store the fix the carbon dioxide, this get the carbon dioxide inside them. And when this photosynthesis will be done, not in a night, but the photosynthesis will be done during the day period. The whatever the malic acid having different types of a CO2, which is collected inside them, they will go back to the chloroplast and they will synthesize the food material. Students, last one. So friends, to crack any examination, just dreams, the only dreams are not fulfills your purpose there, but you have to just like a Ziddi. If you are a Ziddi, life will be yours. So with this, I would like to conclude here. It is a very large topic, but I tried, it's the outline. I just covered the outline here. So my best wishes with you, and with that, thank you very much. Good day.